Hello, Junior Squirrel Squad. I have the wrong book. Which, of course, you can listen to also, but you know, for juniors, we're reading out of this book. Okay. Granny Hopes. Oh, yeah. We can read this one. It's a short one. Yay! Because the senior squirrels have a long chapter. And I don't know if I can get through it, but we'll see. This is called... Can you see that? The Lad Who Went to the North Wind. Once upon a time, there was an old widow who had one son, and as she was poorly and weak, her son had to go out into the shed to fetch meal for cooking. But when he got outside the shed and was just going down the steps, there came the North Wind, puffing and blowing, caught up in the meal, and so away with it through the air. The lad went back again into the shed for more, but when he came out on the steps, if the North Wind didn't come again and carry off the meal with a puff. And more than that, it did it a third time. At this, the lad got very angry. And as he thought it hard that the North Wind should behave so, decided he'd just look him up and ask him to give him back his meal. It's cornmeal, like what you make cornbread out of. So off he went, by the way, but the way was long, and he walked and walked, but at last he came to the North Wind's house. "Good day," said the lad, "and thank you for coming to see us yesterday."
"Good day,"
answered the North Wind, for his voice was loud and gruff.
"And thanks for coming to see me. What do you want?"
"Oh," answered the lad, "I only wished to ask you to be so good as to let me have that meal you took for me on the shed steps, for we haven't much to live on, and if you're going to go on snapping up the morsels we have, there'll be nothing for us but to starve."
"I haven't your meal," said the North Wind, "but if you are in such need, I'll give you a cloth which will get you everything you want if you will only say, 'Cloth, spread yourself and serve up all kinds of good dishes.'"
With this, the lad was well content, but as the way was so long, he couldn't get home in one day. So he turned in to an inn on the way. When they were going to sit down to supper, he laid the cloth on a table which stood in the corner and said, "Cloth, spread yourself and serve up all kinds of good dishes." He hardly said so before the cloth did as it was bid, and all who stood by thought it was a fine cloth, but most of all the landlord. So when all were fast asleep, at the dead of night he took the lad's cloth and did up another in its stead, just like the one he had got from the North Wind, but which couldn't so much as serve up a bit of dry bread. When the lad awoke, he took his cloth and went off with it home to his mother. "Now," said he, "I've been to the North Wind's home, and a good fellow he is, for he gave me this cloth. When I say to it, 'Cloth, spread yourself and serve up all kinds of good dishes,' I get any sort of food I please." "All very true, I dare say," said his mother, "but seeing is believing. I shall not believe it until I see it." The lad made haste, drew out a table, laid the cloth on it, and said, "Cloth, spread yourself and serve up all kinds of good dishes." But never a bit of dry bread did the cloth serve up. "Well," said the lad, "there's no help for it but to go back to the North Wind again." And away he went. He came late in the afternoon to where the North Wind lived. Good evening, said the lad.
Good evening, said the North Wind.
I want my rights for that meal of ours which you took, said the lad, for that cloth you gave me isn't worth a penny.
I've got no meal, said the North Wind, but yonder you have a ram, which coins nothing but golden ducats as soon as you say, ram, ram, make money.
The lad thought this a fine thing, but as it was too far to get home that day, he stayed overnight in the same inn where he had slept before. Before he called for anything, he tried the truth of what the North Wind had said of the ram and found it all right. The landlord stood watching and thought it was a famous ram. When the lad had fallen asleep, guess what? He took the ram and put in its place one that looked exactly the same, but which could not coin so much as a copper penny. Next morning, off went the lad. When he arrived home, he said to his mother, after all, the North Wind is a jolly fellow, for now he has given me a ram which can coin golden ducats if only I say, ram, ram, make money. And I don't know if I'm saying it right or not. D-U-C-A-T-S. I've heard of it before, but I'm not sure if I'm saying it right. All very true, I dare say, said his mother, but I shan't believe it until I see the ducats made.
Ram, ram.
Ooh, I'm talking like the North Wind. Ram, ram, make money, said the lad, but the ram could not. The lad was very angry and went back again to the North Wind and said the ram was worth nothing and he must have his rights for the meal.
Well, said the North Wind, I've nothing else to give you but that stick in the corner yonder. But it's such a stick that if you say, stick, stick, lay on, it lays on till you say, stick, stick, now stop.
The lad took the stick and thanked the North Wind. As the way was long, the lad stopped with the same landlord. But as he could pretty well guess how things stood as to the cloth and the ram, he lay down at once on the bench and began to snore as if he were asleep. Now the landlord, who easily saw that the stick must be worth something, hunted up one which was like it. And when he heard the lad snore, was going to change the two. But just as he was about to take it, the lad cried out, stick, stick, lay on. The stick began to beat the landlord till he jumped over the chairs, tables, and benches and screamed aloud, oh my, oh my, bid the stick be still, else there will be nothing left of me. And you shall have back both your cloth and your ram. When the stick thought the landlord had had enough, he said, stick, stick, now stop. Then he took the cloth and put it in his pocket and went home with the stick in his hand, leading the ram by a cord around its horns. And so he got his rights for the meal he had lost. The end. And tomorrow we'll have Snowdrop and the Seven Little Dwarfs. All right? How about that? Okay, here's a little bookmark for that. And be sweet. Don't be ugly. Love you. Bye-bye.